This morning, we will be singing an anthem by my good friend and arranger, Mary McDonald, entitled "Behold Our God."
Hello, everyone, and happy Easter. God bless each of you for joining us today for our celebration of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Today, we come from the cemetery here in Dadeville. I decided to come here not because I was looking for the living amongst the dead, but I came here because this is a peaceful place. a peaceful place where the saints that have long gone before us are resting. They're waiting upon the second coming of Jesus Christ. They're waiting, and one day, as an old preacher told me long ago, one day this place will look like fresh plowed ground. It will be a great and mighty happening that happens here when the trumpets sound, and those that have put their faith in Jesus Christ will be resurrected as Christ was resurrected. Today I want to read from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, beginning with verse 1. Hear the word of God. It says, "After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, 'Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who is crucified. He is not here. He has risen. Just as he said, come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples that he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you.' So the women turned and hurried and went away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell the disciples. And suddenly Jesus met with them. 'Greetings,' he said. They came to him and clasped his feet and worshiped him. And then Jesus said to them, 'Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me.'" A lot's going on in the scriptures today as we look at this great happening of Easter, resurrection morning, as we come here in faith and we look to see the good news. We find that we are met with an angel. You see, when we come seeking God, we will find God. And when we draw near to God, it is there that we often become afraid. We become afraid, and it is the Spirit of God that calms us. It was the Spirit of God that calmed the Marys. And it was there that they were told twice. They were told first by the angel that sat on the rock, the stone that had been rolled away from the tomb. It was there that the angel sat, and the women came and they were afraid. And he told them, "Do not be afraid. You don't have to be afraid. Come. Come and see. Come and see the truth. Come and see the good news." And they went and they saw that Jesus was not there. Hallelujah, Jesus was risen. Hallelujah, Jesus was risen from the grave. But they didn't understand it yet. And it was only when they saw Jesus and began to fall to his feet and began to worship him that they understood about the resurrection. They understood. It came back to them as in a moment of understanding, where it was there that they understood all that he had been teaching them, all that he had been telling them. And now they believed. And Jesus said to go and tell. That was the first commandment to them, was to go and tell. This resurrection story is so amazing. It is so filled with awe and inspiration. And today, as we gather as believers, we too must experience the resurrection again for our lives. And as we draw near to God, yes, we will be afraid. You know, this is a time when we are very afraid in our lives. We're afraid of the pandemic. We're afraid of what might happen in the future. We're afraid that maybe we're wrong. Maybe we're confused. all the things that cause us to be afraid, when we draw near to God, He tells us, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. And then the second thing He does is to tell us to go and to tell others. This is why I believe in the resurrection. The reason that I believe in the resurrection today is because I was told about the resurrection. I was told by people that I trusted, people that I admired, people that I knew were real and trustworthy. They came and told me and explained to me the transformation that happens when we die. The transformation that happens when we die a physical death. The transformation that happens when we die a spiritual death. When we die to Christ. When we allow our selfishness and our own wills to die and accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior. What a glorious and mighty time it is. Hallelujah. He is risen. I believe in the resurrection today. First, because I was told. My grandmother would tell me over and over about Jesus. And she would tell me over and over about how faithful that He has been. And she would witness to me and tell me, even in times of trouble, even in times of darkness, even in times that I became very, very afraid, others would bear witness to me that it's going to be okay. You see, those that had the good news in their heart, those that understood that the future was in the hands of our Savior. The future was in the hands of the one that had been crucified, dead and buried. And then on this day, on this Easter Sunday, He was resurrected from the grave and He lives. He lives and He is with us today. I believe in the resurrection today. First, because I was told of the resurrection. And because I began to see that this was the plan of God all along, to allow us to be reconciled, to be forgiven, to be cleansed and washed clean. I believe in the resurrection today. First, because I was told, and now I believe in the resurrection because I have experienced Jesus. I've experienced Jesus. I have experienced the darkness of the world and then felt peace when Jesus was in my heart. I've experienced the heartache of the flesh. And then I felt the strength of the Spirit that held me up, that held me close to Him and comfort me even into my bones, much more than the flesh could ever comfort me. I was comforted by Jesus when I cried out to Him and wanted to die. I was comforted by Jesus when I was completely surrendered, when I said, Lord, I can't do it on my own. I can't do it on my own. I can't control my life. I don't have any power over my life. I can't be what I want to be. And so I surrender to Your will. Whatever You desire, let me be a child of God. Oh, and I felt His presence. From the moment that I was baptized in the muddy Warrior River, and I came out and I didn't even feel the sharp stones that were beneath my feet, I began to testify, even to my grandmother, even to my saintly grandmother who had witnessed to me. I began to testify to her. I was so excited. I said, Grandmother, He's real. He's real. I feel Him. He's in my heart. He's in my heart, and I know that He's real, and I know that He is going to change my life. I know that I don't have to live defeated anymore. I don't have to live in fear anymore. I have no fear in my heart right now. I know that if I die this very moment, Grandmother, I know that I'll go to heaven. I will be with Jesus. And it spoke to her heart, and she had affirmation. You see, she saw Jesus in me. And she experienced Jesus just one more time. Just one more time, she experienced the love of Jesus when she saw her grandson had given his life to Jesus, and that she knew with all uncertainty, she knew without any shadow of doubt, that I would have everlasting life. I believe in the resurrection because I was told. I believe in the resurrection because I experienced Him. And I believe in the resurrection because He is in my heart and it has been affirmed by everything that I am, everything that I've been, and everything that I will be. The one thing that I prayed for in my life was that I didn't have to live the life that I was living as a child. I didn't have to live abandoned. I didn't have to live around so much anger, so much hate. I didn't have to no longer live afraid of even the people that said they loved me. You see, God gives me the hope in Christ today that I don't have to be afraid. I don't have to be in fear any longer. Because, you know, I can go into the Holy of Holies and I can be with God. I can lay there and be filled. I can bow down before Him and be touched, renewed, lifted up and encouraged. And then I can go forth and be what He wants me to be because of His strength, not mine. I say hallelujah today. Hallelujah, He is risen. Because I believe in the resurrection. Because I was told. And because I've experienced Him. And finally, I believe in the resurrection. And I will speak it to everyone that I come in contact with. Everyone that allows me to witness to them. I will teach them and tell them about the resurrection. Because the resurrection has withstood time. You know, if there was any doubt whatsoever, if there was any reason to believe that this was a hoax, if there is any reason or any inkling to suggest that Jesus was not put in that grave and that He was not resurrected, they would show you His bones. The enemy would reveal to you the bones of Jesus, because without the resurrection, we are nothing. Without the resurrection, we have no hope. Without the resurrection, we are just wasting our time. But hallelujah, there is a resurrection. They can't find the bones of Jesus. They will never find the bones of Jesus. They will never show that this is a hoax. They will never be able to show you. They can suggest all they want, and they can play on your fleshliness and your inability to understand and have wisdom of things. But let me tell you, if you will walk in the transformation of the Holy Ghost, if you will walk in the transformation of the resurrection, if you will walk and commit yourself unto the Lord, the affirmation comes in waves. It will come flowing unto you. It will come flowing unto you, and it will be revealed to you in so many ways. It will be revealed unto you in the sunrise. It'll be revealed in the sunsets. It will be revealed in the rainbows. It will be revealed in the promises and the prophet. The prophetic word, it will continue to be revealed the rest of your life. It will withstand time. That's why I believe in the resurrection. Because my faith is only getting stronger today. My faith is stronger today than it was 4 weeks ago when we had to isolate ourselves. Even in the isolation, even away from people that can encourage me, let me tell you, I have experienced God in so many ways. I've experienced Him in a clarity of understanding. And by reading His Word, I have completely understood more and more and more of His promises. I believe in the resurrection. I am a resurrected child of God. And I pray that you will be. I pray that you will be transformed. And whatever your need today, God is willing and able to meet that need through the cross and through the empty tomb. You see, it was there at the tomb that we were reconciled. As lost people, as people that had no one, Jesus became someone. Jesus became everything to me. He became everything for me, and He'll become everything for you. As we come to that empty tomb today, we have a Heavenly Father. We have a Heavenly Father. We have a Heavenly Father that we can come to, that we can approach, even when we're not worthy. Our sins are forgiven by the blood of Calvary. Friends, become a resurrection people. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid, but walk in peace. Walk in peace and comfort. Walk in a manner that is worthy unto God. Walk Christ-like. My prayer for you today as we conclude is that each of you would become resurrection people, that you would believe it because you've been told, you would believe it because you've experienced it, and you would believe it because it has been solid and withstood the test of time. Friends, I believe that tomorrow will be a new day. The sun will rise and we can wake from our slumber. And until the Lord returns again in all of His glory, we can shout, hallelujah, He is risen. Hallelujah, He is risen. Hallelujah, He is here, right here. May you experience His presence right now. May you experience His presence and walk with Him daily. May you experience His presence and know His grace, His mercy, His love. And may you become an example and a witness of this great act, this great fulfillment of all the prophecy that was prophesied in Jesus' name. May you become a resurrection people. It is Sunday. The Lord has risen, and He is with us. Let us pray together. Oh, Heavenly Father, thank you for this glorious day. Hallelujah, you are risen. Hallelujah, you're here, right here. Oh, Father, I pray that each of us would experience you in a fresh and anointed way today. I pray, God, that you would watch over us and raise us up, Lord. Strengthen us and, Lord, guide our paths. Father, I pray that we would walk without fear, that we would walk with confidence. Confidence in the empty tomb. Confidence in your presence beside us. Oh, God, let us become resurrection people that we might glorify your name, that we might be drawn into your holy presence and not be afraid. Bless those, O Lord, that are in need. Father, pour out your Spirit upon them and heal them. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon them and bless them. Become the Jehovah Jireh, the provider God for each of us, O Lord, during this time of need. And Lord, hear our cries. Hear our cries and come and be with us. Restore us and bless us. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, and may your week be filled with great joy. May you truly live out this glorious Easter. As Easter people, as resurrection people, may we not only bear witness to the empty tomb, but may we bear witness to our hearts that are filled with the love of Jesus. God bless you. Amen.